Hello, 7th standard students. Today we are going to start to solve our exercise 4.4 of simple equation. In the last session, we have studied about how we can solve the equation to find out a perfect solution, and from one solution, we can make many equations. And now, in this exercise, we are going to solve word problems. Look at here. The first question: set up equation and solve them to find the unknown numbers in the following cases. Add 4 to 8 times a number and you get 60. Now look at here, add 4, that means plus 4 to 8 times. 8 times, that means we have to do your multiplication process. A number, but which number, that we don't know. So let that number be x or y and something, whatever you can take this, and you get 60. Now look at here, let the number be x. So 8 times of this number, that means 8 into x, that is 8x. So now we are going to add this 4, so 8x plus 4, and we get here 60. So as like this, we can form the equation. Okay, now plus 4, now we have to separate the terms, which consisting only constant and which consisting coefficient and variable. So this plus 4, so we have to transpose this 4 to the RHS and it becomes here negative 4. So 8x is equal to 60 minus 4, we get here 8x is equal to 56. Now 8x, that means 8 multiply by x. So now to separate the numbers and alphabets, we have to do a dividing process to the both side by 8. So we get here 8x upon 8 is equal to 56 upon 8. So this 8 and this 8 will cancel each other. So 8 ones are 8 and 8 sevens are 56. So x is equal to 7 is the solution of a given word equation. Second, 1/5 of a number minus 4 gives 3. 1/5, that means 1 upon 5 of a number, that we have to imagine that number minus 4 gives 3. Now look at here, let the number be x. 1/5 of this number, that means x upon 5. Okay, 1 upon 5x, that is x upon 5. So x upon 5 minus 4, it gives us 3. This is our equation. Now we have to solve this. So minus 4 is there. So by transposing method to the, we are going to transpose this 4 to the RHS and we get here x upon 5 is equal to minus 4 becomes here positive plus 4. So x minus 5, x upon 5 is equal to 3 plus 4. And we get here x upon 5 is equal to 7. So multiplying both sides by 5, we get here x multiplied by 5 upon 5 is equal to 7 into 5. So this 5 and this 5 will cancel each other. And x is equal to 7, 5s are 35. This is our equation, solution of a given word equation. So as like this, when you are going to form the equation from the word problem, you have to go word by word. Yes, dear students, you have to go word by word because it is necessary, it is very important to form the equation. If you lose or if you miss any word while reading the sum, your equation will be wrong. Okay? So see, if I take 3/4 of a number and add 3 to it, I get 21. If I take 3/4, that means 3 upon 4 of a number, that means we have to imagine that number and add 3, so plus 3 to it and get 21. So my equation, let the number be x. 3/4 of this number x, that means 3 upon 4x, that is 3x upon 4. And now we are going to add 3, so 3 upon 4x plus 3 is equal to 21. So now plus 3 is transposing to the RHS and we get here 3 upon 4x is equal to 21 plus 3 becomes here minus 3. So 3 upon 4x is equal to 21 minus 3 is 18. So now we have to separate this coefficient and variable. So 3 upon 4. So multiplying this both side by 4 divided by 4 is there. So we have to do here multiplying to the both side by 4, and here we get 3x upon 4 into 4 is equal to 18 upon 4. So this 4 and this 4 will cancel each other and we get 3x. 18 4s are 72. Now 3 is for the multiplication. So now we are dividing both side by 3, because always we are using opposite process. So dividing both sides by 3, we get here 3x upon 3 is equal to 72 upon 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3. X is equal to 3 ones are 3, 24 threes are 72. So X is equal to 24. Anwar thinks of 5 upon 2 of a number, and if he takes away 7 from the number, the result is 23. We don't know that number, so we will let that number be X. Now Anwar thinks of 5 upon 2 of a number. So 5 upon 2 of this number is 5x upon 2, or you can say 5 upon 2x. So if he takes away from 7, that means 5x upon 2 minus 7. Take away 7, that means minus 7. And we get, and the result is 23. So my equation is 5x upon 2 minus 7 is equal to 23. So 5x upon 2 is equal to 23 plus 7. By transposing 7 to RHS, we get here 5x upon 2 is equal to 30. So multiplying both side by 2, we get here 5x into 2 upon 2 is equal to 30 into 2. So this 2 and this 2 will cancel each other. So 5x is equal to 60. So dividing both side by 5, because 5 is for the multiplication, so now we have to separate the coefficient and variable, so we have to divide both side by 5, and we get here 5x upon 5 is equal to 60 upon 5. So this 5 and this 5 will cancel each other. 5 ones are 5 and 12 fives are 60. So x is equal to 12. Question number 2, solve the following. The teacher tells the class that the highest marks obtained by a student in her class is twice of the lowest mark plus 7. The highest score is 87. What is the lowest score? Students, these sums are very important in the point of your exam. The teacher tells the class that highest mark obtained by the student in her class is twice. Twice, that means 2 multiply the lowest mark plus 7 plus 7. And the highest score is 87. What is the lowest score? So they told us to find out the lowest score. So let the lowest score be L. The 2 into lowest score plus 7 is equal to highest mark. How we can find this? Our condition is the teacher tells that the class that the highest mark obtained by, that means highest mark is equal to twice the lowest mark, that means twice by 2 multiply by L. So 2 into lowest mark plus 7. So our equation is 2L plus 7. And you know that the equation, how you can solve this. So 2L is equal to 87 minus 7, that is transposing 7 to the RHS, and we get here 2L is equal to 80. And now we have to find out the value of L. So now we are, 2 is for the multiplication, now we are dividing both sides by 2. So we get here 2L upon 2 is equal to 80 upon 2. So this 2 and 2 will cancel each other. So 18 upon 2 is equal to, L is equal to 40. So the lowest score is 40. B. An isosceles triangle, the base angles are equal. The vertex angle is 40 degree. What are the base angles of the triangle? Now you have to remember that the sum of three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Now isosceles triangles means what? That out of the three sides, two sides are equal and the base angle are also same. So base angles, let that base angle be B, and according to the condition the vertex angle is 40 degree. Now look at here, let the base angle be equal to B and the sum of all interior angles of a triangle is 180 degree. It is our rule related to the sum of the angles of a triangle. So which triangles are the angles are there? B and 40 degree. So B plus B plus 40 degree is equal to 180 degree. So we get here 2B plus 40 degree is equal to 180 degree. So plus 40 will become here minus 40 by transposing 40 degree to the RHS. And we get 2B is equal to 140 degree. Now 2B is there, 2 is for the multiplying. Now we are going to dividing both sides by 2 and we get 2B upon 2 is equal to 140 upon 2. So this 2 and this 2 will be cancelled with each other and B is equal to 70 degree. So the base angle of the triangle is 70 degree. C. Sachin scored twice as many runs as Rahul. Together their runs fell too short of a double century. How many runs did each one score? Let the Rahul scores be X. Therefore, Sachin's score is equal to 2X. So, look at here. Sachin scored twice as many as Rahul. So, we know that Sachin made a twice runs as many as Rahul. But we don't know about the Rahul's run. So, let the Rahul scores be X. And therefore, Sachin's scores is 2X. And together, that means we have to do here addition. So, Rahul score plus Sachin scores fell too short of a double century. Double century, double means 2 and century means 100. So, multiply by 100. And too short, that means 2 runs get lesser than 2 double century. So, 200 minus 2. So we get here 2x plus 2 is equal to 198. Dear students, do you get this? Together, that means Rahul's score and Sachin's scores, we have to add. But when we are going to add the scores of both Rahul's and Sachin, we get too short, that means two runs are minimum to make a double century. So 200 minus 2, that we get here 198. So 2x plus 3x is equal to 3x is equal to 198. So 3x, that means 3 multiply by x. So we are going to divide both sides by 3 so that 3 cancel with each other. So 3x divided by 3 is equal to 198 divided by 3. So these 3 and this 3 will cancel with each other. And we get here x is equal to 66. So Rahul's score is 66. And Sachin's scores is 2 into 66, that is 132. Question 3, solve the following. Irfan says that he had 7 marbles more than 5 times the marbles Parmeet has. Irfan has 37 marbles. How many marbles does Parmeet have? Now we have to find out the numbers of marbles which have the Parmeet. So let the Parmeet's marble equal X. Now according to condition, 5 times the numbers of marbles Parmeet has, that means 5X, and he has 7 marbles more, that means 7 plus. So 5X plus 7, and total if I'm having 37 marbles. So my equation is 5X plus 7 is equal to 37. Dear students, it is very important that you have to find out the perfect equation. and to find out the perfect equation you have to go word by word. So 5x is equal to 37 minus 7. So this, by transposing this 7 to the RHS, it converted into negative 7, and we get here 37 minus 7, that is 30. So now 5x is there, so 5 is for the multiplication. So now we are going to divide this both side by 5. So that 5 will be cancelled with each other. Look at here, as like this. 5x upon 5 and is equal to 30 upon 5. So 5 and this 5 will cancelled each other. 5 ones are 5, 5 6 are 30. So x is equal to 6. Therefore Parmeet has 6 marbles. Now the second question, Lakshmi's father is 49 year old. He is 4 years older than 3 times Lakshmi's age. Okay, what is the Lakshmi's age? Now we have to imagine the something that is a Lakshmi's age. He is, that means Lakshmi's father is 4 years older. Older, that means he is a bigger. So plus 4, then 3 times, that means 3 multiply by. Okay, so let the Lakshmi's age be x years, and according to the condition, Lakshmi's father is 4 years older, that is plus 4, than 3 times of Lakshmi's age, that means 3 into Lakshmi's age, so we will get her father's age. So my equation is 3 into x plus 4 is equal to 49, because we imagine that Lakshmi's age is x, and we know that the her father's age is 49. So my equation is 3x plus 4 is equal to 49. So now we have to separate the constant from the terms which we consist coefficient and variables. So by using transposing method, we will transpose this 4 to the right hand side, and we get here 3x is equal to 49 minus 4. This plus 4, positive 4, becomes here negative 4. And by on subtracting, we get here 3x is equal to 45. Now 3x, now we have to separate the coefficient and variable. So coefficient is for the multiplication process. To cancel it, we have to divide this both side by 3, and we get here 3x upon 3 is equal to 45 upon 3. So this 3 and this 3 will cancel each other, and we get x is equal to 15. So Lakshmi's age is 15 years. Is it easy? You have to find out the correct equation, and to find out the correct equation you have to go word by word, so you can find out the correct equation. Now the third one is, people of Sundar Gram planted trees in the village garden. Some of the trees were fruit trees, and the number of non-fruit trees were 2 more than 3 times of the number of fruit trees. What was the number of fruit trees planted? The number of non-fruit trees planted was 77. Okay, now look at here. Let the number of fruit trees be x. We have to find out the number of fruit trees. So let that number of fruit trees be x. Now look at here. The condition is the number of non-fruit trees was 2 more. That means 2 plus than 3 times. That means 3 multiply the number of fruit trees. So according to condition, 3 into x, 2 plus 3 into x, that is 3 into number of fruit trees plus 2 is equal to number of non-fruit trees, and the number of non-fruit trees are 77. So my equation is 3x plus 2 is equal to 77. Do you get this, students? Let the number of fruit trees be x, and according to condition, 2 more, that means plus 2, then 3 times of the number of fruit x. 3 times, that means 3 multiply by, and the number of fruit trees are x, so 3x. So my equation is 3x plus 2 is equal to 77. And you know that how to solve the equation. So try to solve this equation yourself. I will wait for the few minutes. So dear student, check it yourself. Therefore, the number of fruit trees was 25. Okay, have you checked yourself? It is the right answer. Oh, very good. Now, there is a one riddle for the question number 4. I am a number. Tell my identity. Take me 7 times over and add 50. To reach a triple century, you still need 40. Now look at here. I am a number. So let that number, we have to imagine that. Take me 7 times, that means 7 multiply and add 50. So we have to add 50. To reach the triple century, triple that means 3 and century that means 100. So we have to do here multiplication. You still need 40, that means you still need 40, that means there are 40 less number is there. So look at here how we can solve this. Let the number be x. So 7x plus 50, look at here, 7 times, that means 7 times of x, that means 7x, add 50, that means plus 50. To reach triple century, that means 3 into 100, that is 300, and need 40, that means you have to add 40 number more. So my equation is 7x plus 50 plus 40 is equal to 300. So we get here 7x plus 90 is equal to 300. So transposing this 90 to the RHS, we get here 7x is equal to 300 minus 90. So 7x is equal to 210. So by dividing both sides by 7, we get here 7x upon 7 is equal to 210 upon 7. So by cancelizing this 7, we get here x is equal to 30. So that number is 30. So as like this, you have to solve this exercise 4.4. So dear student, this is your homework, that you have to solve this exercise in your notebook. Watch this video carefully again and again. Listen this video carefully and try to solve this exercise 4.4 in your notebook yourself. Till then, have a good day.